Well, it's Saturday morning. Me and old Boo Boo are having some coffee at the table. He's in my chair. He moved me out. When I got up, he jumped in my chair. That's the kind of guy he is. Gonna be a knife day, too. I got a lady bring me some knives. I gotta pick up some knives. I don't know what it's gonna be like. We'll know more soon. Well, the lady just dropped off the chef's knife. She's a chef, sous chef at a local place here. This one says it's a F. I don't know what the hell that is. High quality stainless steel, 100% handmade. And she's got a emerald. That chef guy. I don't know about them two. And then she's got two of these. Emperor steel. Household Japan. Stainless steel. Okay, that's the first deal for Saturday. They got a few scratches in them. This one's got a few. Not many here. A few here. I'm going to clean them up for a little bit, too. I told you it was going to be a knife day. I still don't know what kind. But I did pick up the knives from the juice bar. Stand by me. Let me get them out. We got a Dexter. We got two little Paras. I don't know what kind they are. I don't see any names on them. They look like they ought to be Dexters. Nope. They're, some kind of chef's thing like you get at the, BJ's or Sam's. Got two of those. Got a lasting cut, which you've seen a lot of. But this is a 10-inch one. Got a lasting cut serrated knife. And tools of the trade, China, serrated bread knife. Okay, I got to work on a tomato slicer a little longer. Got to take it back today, so I got to go to work. Stand by. This is a 25 micron. Finished up on the green, which is a coarse. This is a medium. And then one of my YouTubers said, use your Spyderco rod. So I stuck it in there like this. As you can see, I just stuck it in there like that and pulled it back and forth. This is a fine. I have the medium. I didn't use the medium. Just to tune up the edges a little bit. It's hard to do with one hand and you work the camera, but I hold it with the other hand so it don't move. You get the idea. We're getting ready to test it in a minute. Stand by. Look what the mailman just brought. I may have to give that a try. I don't have any tomatoes to test, but we'll see. Okay. Well, it seems sharp. I ain't heard from the guy, so I'm just going to take it over there. If he's there, he's there. If he's not, I'll leave it.
I think it'd be a little bit more sharper where we were not pushing it through it. You should be able to just push right through it. If you compare it to that one. That way.
This is with the new blade. Ain't bad though. Maybe slice them right up. Yeah. Yours is a little sharper.
Like if we can get it to like, would you be able to get it to like this level sharper?
I don't. Yeah. That one passed the test. We got another one. I told him I'd do the first one as a sample for no charge. With that bad blade. Now we got a new one. I mean a dull one. It's got no breakings in the blade, but it has a few little nicks here and there. $25, I told him. He said, okay. He said the new blade is $45. And I said it was a Hardee's. I don't know where I got that from. It's a Wendy's. Back to the drawing board. Well, I just picked up the last of the knives for Saturday. Excuse me a minute. It's a whole set of white Chicago cutleries. I mean, white handle Chicago cutleries. Scissors. Bread knife. Utility knife. Para. Santuco. Baby Santuco. They're not in too bad a shape. They're just dull. And they need a little bit of cleanup. They're kind of gray. So we got knives. I may try to do these today and be done with the knives and take a break tomorrow. I was going to go watch the Masters, but I'm trying to make my mind up. Stand by. Well, they're all out of the dishwasher. All buffed up and polished. I'm done with knives for Saturday. Maybe Sunday too. It's a shade after six. Look. My buddy says, get your tail out of here. Big old Jack, you ready? Uh-oh, come on, Pip, let's get that balls, boy. Let's wait, let's go, let's go. Carnivore, you hungry? You are? Who didn't know that? Yeah. Where's your buddy? Oh, there's your buddy right there, look at him. Big boo-boo. I'm hungry too. Give me some food. Look how big he is. Good gracious, he's big. Say hello, big boo-boo. I like to bite your hand. I know that. What are you Indians want? Hey, come on, come on. Let's go, let's go. Let's go. Punishment for the bay. This is just east of the cave. Cave will be done like this probably by the end of the week or the first of next week. Sand is coming from those ships right there. Probably Weeks Marine. That's what it looks like before. The cave is just to the left. Is that something? That's the finish part. The big beach is right there. We hunt the big beach.
Gigmaster. See what he says? That's the same thing I sent you the pictures of at first. He's got a video. Check it out. I'm afraid the cave is going to be no longer for a while. For sale. Or best offer. Some nice stuff in here. That's a dirt digger, knife, pin pointer, pocket knife. I hate to tell you what's in here. But there's a brand spanking new, never used dollar scoop. Excavator 2.22. Should be able to see it. Right there. Stavoscoop scoop excavator 2.22. That's about $140, $150 plus the freight. Never been in the water, never had a handle in it. You've seen enough of these to know what they are. $300, I'll get it. Sight unseen. A friend of mine bought all this some time back. You remember the scoop? I bought the scoop from one of Roslyn's customers. They didn't like it, so they wanted a different model. They ordered the wrong model or something. I had a video on it when I did it, but it was about a year ago. Anyway, Roslyn had the guy send it to me, and I put it on in one of my videos, and this person that I know bought it, and then bought all this stuff to go with it. Never been used. I hate to open this up. Open up the good stuff first. Gonna pull all out of that's pouches. Calico, you know, waste pouches where you put your treasure in. But wait a minute, I gotta get that knife out of there. You know how Calico puts packages together? You buy the whole package, you get everything. Well, in that is this locked back knife. Brand spanking, never been out of the box. Brand spanking gator. Never been out of the sheath. Come off of there, you turkey-legged varmint. Stand by a minute. Dirt digger. Gator. Brand spanking new. Heavy duty. Now this is some kind of probe. A Vulcan 360 probe. I don't know anything about Vulcan 360 probes. I imagine it's some of them Calico deals, you know. All right, you know what's in the small bag. Keep thinking $300. They'll say this is a fine carrying case right here. Fine carrying case. And there's a detector right here. Waterproof. Are you ready for it? Beach magnet. I ain't going no further with this. Those of you who know, You do realize it is a nice carrying case. Brand new coil, brand new detector, never been on the beach, never had the batteries put in it. You want to know more about it? You go look it up on, what's the name of that place? Calico. Oh my God. Anyway, like I said, you get a nice pocket knife, a nice dirt digger, some kind of probe, pinpointer, I mean. Nice, very nice carrying case. And a brand spanking new excavator 2.22 Stava scoop. I'm gonna stick it on a Treasure Depot sometime this afternoon or tonight, maybe in the morning. I'm sort of reluctant to do it, but she's a friend of mine and she's getting shipped overseas. I know, don't go there, okay? Just don't go there.